English because I promised. So excuse me if I make mistakes, but we're going to start with the ceremony in Redmond, and I want to ask you to all come in, and I have a special place for the parents, so if you come in, please. Pronounce your city,
Chattanooga. Yes.
Chattanooga in Tennessee. And there's a beautiful big town, and I've read about it on Wikipedia and everything, and it's wonderful. I will introduce myself. I hope you can understand me in my English. Yeah? Gaat het? Beter? Yeah? Okay. My name is Herbert Horst. I'm the city beagle, I think. Of the city Gouda, and I'm going to confirm your marriage. What I'm going to do is first, the witnesses, and I've seen them already, the witnesses, and then I'm going to tell something about Gouda, because it is so special here, and special room, and special kind of castle, with the prince and princess. Then I'm going to tell something about you. Huh? how you've met and about the chess roulette in September 2011, about the pillows.
Yeah.
With the Skype. Yeah. And what you like most of each other. Then I go to the official part. Official part, which is the magical word, yes. And then I'm going to ask Ivory. That's you. You are going to give beautiful rings to them after the word yes. Then we go to Simon behind the table. And at the end, I will read a little poem for you, which I made especially for you. Two witnesses, yeah, of course, we found them all. And that is special. You may put your autograph.
We feel old.
And yeah. And also you are with them, of course, in difficult periods. You, as a witnesses, you always have to cooperate and help them in difficult times. You made some nice pictures here, in Gouda. Have you been to the Golden Lail already? You're going later on. You go afterwards. You go. Because the Golden Lion. Rachel, I will want to explain a little bit about Dutch history and about lions.
Okay.
We never had lions here in Holland, but in our coat of arms we have the lion. And the lion, for instance, here they are. The lion. This is the coat of arms of Gouda, and we have the stars, and not the stripes, but we have the stars, and the how do you call it? The thorns. Per asper ad astra. And you know that because you know all about the astronomy, about the skies, about the stars. You go through the stars, through the thorns, to the stars. Which is quite wonderful. And we are a land of water. Wet farmers, they are walking on wooden blocks. You know that, in Tennessee. Mm-hmm. Do you know something about Tennessee?
Not much.
No, shall I explain a little bit? Do you know who is coming from Tennessee? Elvis Presley. Elvis Presley was from Tennessee. And Dolly Parton came there. And you know, the Coca-Cola factory, they started there. Mm-hmm. That was a long time ago in 19...
I don't know.
But I know that there is also Chattanooga, the Cho-Cho. Eh? You know, Glenn Miller wrote a song about it.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, they wrote a song about it, about the train. Train. Elvis Presley wrote about it. Love me tender, love me do. In this town hall, we have texts all about love. And they are texts from the Bible. They are from the Corinthians. And in this window, I'm going to teach you a little bit. Said the word, Liefde vergaat nimmer meer. And you can translate it into love.
And love doesn't pass.
Yeah. Pass anymore. Love is eternal. Yeah. That's what it means. We've been interviewing in the new Stadhuis and. I asked, how did you meet each other? But how can somebody who lives in the United States and the other one is in Bali or you were in Lady Stuff, the distance is so far. And then you have met, of course, through the internet. And that was by the chat roulette. because you knew two friends, Rachel, and through that chat through that you had met each other. And on Facebook. Because you know Facebook, if you have the line in the site, and it was a fallout, the program, the fallout. And you were chatting with each other, and suddenly you saw the chat. And you grabbed the chat, and there was the contact between you. If that was a little bit later, then you were sitting. That was quite a coincidence. You've Skyped a lot.
Yeah.
You've Skyped amazing a lot. Unbelievable. And also, when you were Skyping and you had dinner appointments, and you were dressed nicely in Skype, and you were having dinner together, that was very special. Darcy, you have been 2 times to the States, and you've met family over there, and it was a warm welcome there for you. And you know, like sports, and Rachel especially, you like volleyball.
Yes.
In your garden, there is no volleyball net. And Darcy thought, okay, I'm going to make that holes for her, make a volleyball net, and one day it was a volleyball net, so they could play volleyball there, which was great. Rachel, you told me, Darcy is very creative.
Yes.
And he can make, he's not only creative in words, you call him the pun master, woordgrappen, zijn dat? And but also with playing the piano, that is something that you also adore. The marriage proposal. It was on internet, in February, on Skype, and afterwards you posted it on Facebook. What you did last 2 weeks ago was also very nice. You went to Köln, and there in Köln you have a station, I think, and a bridge over the River Rhine. And there you can buy a locker. You can hang the locker on the bridge. Mm-hmm. Then you have the key. Throw the key into the water. That's what you did. That's very symbolic. So that is love. How do you call that? Onafscheidelijk love. Dat is een hele mooie symbool. A very beautiful symbol. To do that together. When I ask you what you like most of each other, and Darcy, you said. The first thing, she liked the video game. That's what you also like. And you like the different culture. You are open for different cultures, you are open for other things. And the big plus is that you can talk with each other about everything. And you said she's beautiful and she's sweet and intelligent. And you like same things together. Rachel, you said about Darcy, you like to hear him singing and playing the piano, which is beautiful. And you like his humor, I already told you.
Yeah.
Pun master, for me, a new word. That's what you like. And you said, can make me laugh. Like it's good life.
Yeah.
That's what you said. And he my advice. What is your key to your marriage? The key to your marriage is already in the river. And try to search it for it. My advice, sing songs, play the piano, be creative, and love each other every day. Remember always in your life the first time you've met each other, and never break promise ring. Now I'm going to the official part. May I ask you to stand up from your seat and give each other the right hand?
Left hand.
Left hand?
Yes. In America, it's the left hand.
Okay. Yeah, for the rings.
Yeah.
Yeah. But you have to give each other the right hand in. Okay.
Give each other the right hand.
Yes, that is okay. That's correct. That is correct. Please. Do you take Darcy Jonathan Schmidt as your wedded wife, Rachel McKinsey Lane, and do you really fulfill all the duties which are imposed by the Dutch law? What is your answer, Darcy?
I do.
Thank you very much. Do you take Rachel McKinsey Lane as your wedded husband, Darcy Jonathan Schmidt, and do you loyally fulfill all the duties which are imposed by the Dutch law? And what is your answer?
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Then I hereby solemnly declare the marriage of Darcy Jonathan Schmidt and Rachel McKinsey Lane as sealed.
Yeah.
Beautiful. Very nice. Now I will invite you to come behind the table and go this side. Thank you very much. Please stay here for the witness. And first of all, I want to have Joke up as witness. Thank you. sign. And then this everything is released. Congratulations. Congratulations.
Yeah.
Please take a seat. So, married, great congratulations. I promised you to read the poem which I made for you. And I was a bit inspired, of course, of you, Darcy, the way you gave Rachel all the roses, every day all the roses. So, my poem is called The Leaves of Roses. Leaves of roses are like the colors of the rainbow, in between the sun and rain. It can see my love for you will grow, and forever it will remain. Clouds will disappear by the wind of love and open the beautiful sky above. Then I see the flowers in your hand and I hear birds singing in the sky. My love for you is more than just a friend. Together we love and together we cry. It's our feeling that expresses our love. It's written in the wind and in the sky. Ik wens iedereen ook een hartelijke felicitatie. U ook. You are going to the windmill. You take beautiful pictures. The weather is great.
Perfect.
And I hope you enjoy your day. And please greet your parents in Tennessee there. Ik hoop dat jij toen op Stadia de planning was gefeliciteerd. Hartelijk gefeliciteerd. Jij ook gefeliciteerd.
Ja, ze hebben niet voor een trouwboekje aangekomen.
Ja, het is normaal. En wat heb je de poem?
Thank you.
Kom hier.
Jemco, de Pemco.
Ja?
Ja, ja.
Gefeliciteerd.
Dankjewel. Dankjewel.
Give me a hug.
Congratulations. My turn now.
Ooh. Yes, I know he does.
I'm a what?
You love the camera, don't you? Don't put it on me, please. That's why I was filming.
Uh-huh. It was all for me.
You like that? Yeah.
Mr. and Mrs. Smith.
Exactly.
Mr. and Mrs. Smith. Actually, people sell that.
Okay. Like, when do the spice stuff start?
No. Spice.
Ik kan beter horen.
Dat je oren roken zo.
Ik kan beter horen.
Aha. Uh-huh.